Season 4 Turkey Hunter TV, we're excited to bring you guys some new content. We busted our butts last spring. We killed a bunch of birds. We're going to start this season, and you guessed it, Texas, at one of our favorite places, the Four Seasons Ranch, and Seth and Reno are up to bat first.
Turkey Hunter is brought to you by Browning, the best there is.
Texas is one of our favorite places to turkey hunt, and this week we're in South Texas. The cool thing about Texas is, you know, all these other states are complaining about declining turkey populations. Texas is not. It is unbelievable. Every year they have a great hatch, and it just seems like there's more and more birds each year. And the cool thing about these birds is they will come to your call. And if he gobbles at your call, you better sit down and get ready. I've said it before, because he's going to be in your lap in a matter of moments. So we get to the Four Seasons. Spring has sprung. It's starting to green up. And so we're super excited, and Seth and Reno head out for their first sit of the spring.
What you think, Reno?
I don't know, it's a pretty morning. Came in over here the other day and put some cameras out. I don't know how many times we saw when we went in there to put a camera, but they were several.
It's just gonna be a matter of time.
Yep. Have a little patience. That's what turkey hunting's about. A little foggy this morning. Guys, we went out and roosted some last night. There's a whole big flock in this area we're going in. So we are a little bit early, but we're gonna try to get in there and get us a good spot picked out, put some decoys out, and hopefully they'll be gobbling on the roost. All right, let's do it. So let's get our stuff and head that way.
Seth and Reno eased in, put out decoys, and get set up. Sure enough, these birds are right where they left them the evening before. Now they're sitting about 150 yards from these birds, and that's close. So Seth decides not to be too aggressive with his calling. He gets his ceramic out, and he clucks two or three times on it, and sure enough, he gets the boss hen excited, and she pitches out and flies right in on the decoy spread. Well, when this hen lights at the decoy, she starts pretty yelping. Now these turkeys in the background are still gobbling, they just ain't closing the distance. So this hen kind of wheels around and he starts going back towards these gobblers.
Okay.
Well, she gets about 50, 60 yards away, and she starts yelping. Perfect time for Seth to grab his ceramic and start yelping back to her. Well, they get to yelping back and forth. Seth is just mimicking her, and each time he does, she yelps back at him. And sure enough, these gobblers get fired up. And like a ghost, this old gobbler emerges from the fog in full strut.
Turkey Hunter is also brought to you by Apex Competitions, Indian Creek Shooting Systems, Replica Decoy Company, Foot on the Head Game Calls, Grounded Brand Turkey Vests, Vortex Optics, Tacticam, and Browning Trail Cameras.
Sign up today for the Apex Spring Turkey Challenge. Over $120,000 in payouts based on the total number of entries in your state. Reward your passion, reward your turkey harvest, and good luck from all of us here at Turkey Hunter TV. Well, when Reno shoots this bird, a group of gobblers answer. Well, Seth picks up his ceramic once again, calls at them, and they gobble. Calls at them again, and they gobble. About 10 minutes goes by, and Reno whispers the words all us turkey hunters love to hear.
Here they come, here they come, here they come, here they come. What a turkey hunt. Had the hen come in the first time.
That was probably the most aggressive morning turkey hunt I have ever seen.
I tell you what.
Did you see that boss hen come flying to the decoys like that?
I did. I did.
This is mine.
Yes, sir. Guys, what a morning in South Texas. A Texas triple. I mean, we had probably the best roost hunt that I've ever experienced.
Oh yeah, it was great.
We came in here and roosted these birds last night about 600 yards away, hit the old raging rooster call, and all these birds in this bottom gobbled. And we made a plan. We were gonna sneak down this Sendero here, probably get about 150 yards. We put the RDC Jake and the feeding hen out there. And it rained last night, real foggy. And I wasn't gonna say much just because I knew we were close. And I could hear their little antsy, like they were gonna fly down. And I just clucked a couple of times. And it wasn't just a few seconds. And I heard whoop, 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 whoop. And the old boss hen lit right in our decoys. She yelped a few, and then she turned and went back towards the flock, and then we started cranking. She and I were back and forth, back and forth.
Yeah, it sounded good, too.
And it wasn't a few seconds, and I looked up, and old Puffy's walking right down the road.
Yep.
He put on show. He was pretty. Came up there and hit the decoy a couple times. And
it was pretty foggy, and him coming through there.
Yep.
It was great. Went to the decoys.
Yep. I told Reno, I said, let him have it, and he did. And this is where the story gets interesting.
Yeah.
Because as soon as I shot, all these birds gobbled together. And I just cranked at them on the old ceramic, and they kept gobbling. And they kept gobbling, and they kind of circled around. And it wasn't 15 minutes, and Reno says, here they come, here they come. And I look up, and there's 5-6 longbeards running down this Sendero straight at the decoy, and they came in there and commenced a whipping on him. And
they gave him a pretty good whipping.
took us a minute to figure out which one you're gonna shoot. And you shot, and they all stood, they all kept flogging and hitting on each other, and I said, I'm gonna grab my shotgun and kill one. And I reached over, made sure I still had him in camera.
Oh, yeah.
And
you checked it right before you shot.
I sure did. I looked, and I decided
I was gonna fill one of my tags, and we have a Texas triple on one fine morning here in South Texas at Four Seasons Ranch.
It's great.
What a morning, buddy. And I couldn't think of a finer person to spend it with.
Oh man, it was great.
Thank you, my friend.
It was great. Thank you. Thank you a bunch.
What a day. Browning trail cameras told us they were here. Old RDC sent them up here. Old Browning Maxis, both of us, cranked down, right?
That's right.
Indian Creek 556 just ate them up.
Oh, man, they didn't hardly flop.
No, they didn't. Nope. What a day. Thank you.
Thank you. Hey, we got time to get you another one.
We do, don't we?
Or this morning.
Whatever.